Hi there, this is DMR and welcome to DMR tutorials. In the previous capsule, we have discussed about the derivation of the equations of motion. V is equal to u plus at, s is equal to ut plus half at square and v square minus u square in the algebraic method. Now in this capsule, we will discuss the derivation of the same equations using graphs. Particularly velocity time graph. In the VT graphs, we will take time on x axis, corresponding velocities on y axis. Let us assume a body started with a velocity of u, its initial position is a, and after a journey of t seconds, the body reached the position b, and at the point b, the final velocity is v. So, initial velocity u, final velocity b, time of journey is t. And A, B, C, O is a trapezium. Let us assume a line passing through A and parallel to OC, that is x-axis, and that is AC, AD. And the line intersects B, C at D, and you have this triangle now. Now the point is, the theta is the angle of elevation of the graph. Now here the important principle is the slope of VT graph. This is the VT graph, its slope. The slope of VT graph gives the acceleration. The formula for slope of VT graph is opposite by adjacent side. So theta is the angle or angle of elevation and its opposite by adjacent, this is 90 degrees. Opposite by adjacent gives you the slope of the line. Therefore, acceleration A is equal to opposite to theta by adjacent to theta. In your higher mathematics, this ratio is called tangent of the angle theta. So that you will get in trigonometry of your 10th class portion, mathematics portion. Anyhow, here the opposite is BD by adjacent is AD. BD is nothing but B minus U. This whole length is V, this small portion is U, this gap will be V minus U by this, this is T and this is also T. So, this is T. So, we come to the conclusion that A is equal to V minus U by T, that implies take cross multiplication, you will get V minus U is equal to A into T and that implies minus U taken to other side of the equality becomes plus U. Then you will get V is equal to U plus AT. So this is the derivation of the first equation of motion, V is equal to U plus AT. And this derivation mainly depends upon the principle that slope of VT graph gives the acceleration and slope is nothing but opposite by adjacent. In the higher level, you will get the same as tangent of the angle theta. So this is the derivation of first equation of motion, V is equal to U plus AT. So after discussing about the derivation of first equation of motion, now let us derive the second equation of motion, S is equal to UT plus half AT square. To derive S is equal to UT plus half AT square also will make use the same graph, same VT graph, time on x axis, velocity on y axis. A is the initial position, B is the final position, U is the initial velocity, V is the final velocity and of course T is the time. And now the statement, the rule useful is the area of VT graph. That means the area of full this part. The shaded region represents the area of VT graph and that area of VT graph gives you the displacement. So statement useful is so area of VT graph gives the displacement S. So the shaded region is in the shape of a trapezium. These two AC, AO and BC are parallels and AD is the distance between the two parallels. And this AB and OC are non-parallel sides. So this total quadrilateral is in the shape of a trapezium. Area of trapezium is half distance into sum of the two sides. So area of OABC is equal to half into distance between the two parallel sides into sum of the two parallel sides. And area of the trapezium, area of VT graphs, this is the displacement S is equal to half. Distance between the two parallel sides is AD. A plus B, sum of the two parallel sides. Length of this side is U. Length of the other side is, of course, OA plus BC, and this is equal to what is AD? AD is nothing but T by 2 into OA. OA is nothing but U plus CB is nothing but V. But from the first equation of motion, we have already derived V is equal to U plus AT. So in the place of V, let us substitute U plus AT. So this is T by 2 times U as it is. In the place of V, substitute U plus AT. And this you will get T by 2 into 2U plus AT, and this is going to with 2, with T by 2 you multiply inside. T by 2 into 2U is UT plus T into T square by 2. So AT square by 2, which is equal to S. And this is the derivation of S is equal to UT plus half AT square, the second equation of motion. So here the principle, the main rule we have applied is the area of velocity time graph gives the displacement. In the previous case, in the derivation of V is equal to U plus AT, we have taken the rule that the slope of VT graph gives the acceleration. Here the area of VT graph gives the displacement, and this is the derivation. Next thing is the derivation of third equation of motion, that is V square minus U square is equal to 2AS. We have derived the first equation V is equal to U plus AT, second equation S is equal to UT plus half AT square graphically. Using these two relations, we can derive the third relation. So let us go for the derivation of third equation of motion, that is V square minus U square is equal to 2AS. Now, from the first equation of motion, we know that V is equal to U plus AT. Take U to left side, becomes minus V minus U is equal to AT. And this you take it as equation number 1. Next thing is, take the second equation of motion. S is equal to ut plus half at square. Go in the reverse process. That is, S is equal to ut plus at square by 2. Take cross multiplication. 2s is equal to ut plus at square. This implies 2s is equal to t into u plus at. But u plus at is nothing but v. So this implies 2s is equal to t into u plus v. Into 2 taken to outside becomes pi t. Then you have v plus u is equal to 2s by t. This is the second relation. First relation we got from first equation. Second relation we got from the second equation of motion. Now here left side is v minus u, here also left side is v plus u. V minus u into v plus u, multiply these left hand sides. V minus u into v plus u. V minus u is nothing but a into t. V plus u is nothing but 2s by t. This t, t gets cancelled, and v minus u into v plus u is v square minus u square, which is equal to 2as. So this is the third equation of motion. So to prove the third equation of motion, we have used first and second equations of motion. And that's it this capsule. I'm signing off. Thank you.